As a scientist, he must in research and academia. And before Abu introduced Bob Collymore to me, I had never met Bob besides seeing him in the media. Likewise, I cared very little about the better option, as I depended on different telecom companies that served me well. Wabui respectfully introduced Bob to me at our home during the early days of dating. Nice meeting you, Bob Collymore. I hope you are serious about my relationship, about your relationship with my daughter. If you are not, and you are just wasting her time, I'll deal with you single-heartedly with my fair little hands. But in little respect, this was very harsh, but Bob just looked at me and smiled. Throughout his loving and wonderful relationship with Wambui, Bob never gave me any single reason to use my fair hands, and it is now my turn to smile back at Bob. I say to Bob's mother and sister, thank you for giving Bob to my family, to Kenya, and to the world. Bob and I shared a very special mother-son-in-law relationship, and I will highlight just one example among many. During one lunch date, he surprised me by hinting that he was frustrated with having to pop many pills for a long time to tame the leukemia. That lunch conversation was the beginning of our death can wait inspirational phrase. Bob's death waited since November 2017. Of course, death will eventually and surely take us, but we all can celebrate the life of Bob Collymore by using our will to defy death, even as we surprise the doctors, just like Bob Collymore did. As your death awaits, will you be making the world a better or a worse place? Will you be building or destroying the world? Let us all learn from Bob Collymore and use our death waiting time to make this world a better and happier place. Rest in peace, my dear son, Bob. And to Bob, we say fare thee well, travel well. May God give you peace. He gave you to us, and he has seen it fit to take you unto himself. May his great name be praised, and the congregation will say, Amen. Thank you.